Okay. Okay, so I was talking about there was a problem in my network connection. That's why it is going down. Okay, let us talk about that now. So AGRP, we are going to discuss that today. Like that last week, we've been doing on the OSPF like that. I'll be talking about the AGRP here. So this AGRP is going to be the enhanced interior gateway routing protocol for to get configured on the Cisco routers on this something. So AGRP can work only on a Cisco router, that everyone knows that. And we are going to configure that the AGRP on the Cisco routers, and we will be verifying the configurations parameters on that. And what are the metrics are used on this, and how we are going to verifying the configurations whichever we made on that. How the topology table has been made, routing table has been made, neighborship has been made. Like that, many other tables which has been created by the EAGRP, which we will come to know. These are all the things I am going to discuss it today. EAGRP, everyone knows that we've been working on for EAGRP for last 20 years and all. So there is no much enhancement has been made, but EAGRP has got some, you know, the integration to the IP version 6 also it is possible. So IP version 4 also EAGRP will work, and IP version 6 also the EAGRP will work on that. So let me go directly to that, you know, to the slides on this. Let me play the slides. Then you will can see that. Once again, let me play the slides. Okay. We are going to describe the basic operations of the EAGRP, planning and implementing the EAGRP routing, configure and verify the EAGRP routing, configure and verify basic EAGRP in an enterprise WAN, configure and verify the authentication and optimization mechanisms, verify and the troubleshoot overall implementation. Like that, this is just a description I would like to talk. You know, what are the capabilities and attributes are there for the EAGRP? EAGRP is a Cisco proprietary distance vector protocol with the link state features. EAGRP features include fast convergence, partial updates, multiple network layer support, use of multicast and unicast communications, variable length subnet masking support, seamlessly connectivity across all data link layers, protocols and technologies. By default, it performs automatic route summarization, and major network boundaries can be disabled but also can be configured to summarize on interfaces like that. So many capabilities are there which we've seen that here, like it's like fast convergence, partial updates are possible, multiple network layer support, use of multicast and unicast for the communications, VLSM support that is very much required for nowadays, and a seamless connectivity to all the data link layer, other things. It can do the route summarizations, and across the network boundaries also we can do that. Like how, what are the things which we can do it on a OSPF? AGRP is also doing that. Next, AGRP terminology. Neighbor table, topology table, routing table, advertised distance, feasible distance, successor, feasible successor, and passive versus active routes. So these are all the terminologies which we need to understand before configuring the EAGRP. Neighborship table, topology table, routing table. These are all the three tables which we normally talk about when we are speaking on EAGRP on this. Advertised distance, feasible successor, these are all, we will be finding it out in the topological tables, we'll find out. Okay, this is the tables which we know, three tables are created. And inside the topology table, we'll find all these things. Advertised distance, feasible distance, successor, and feasible successor. So like by using a metric type on its own, the AGRP will calculate how the neighborship has been performed and how the topology table will be created. Based on the topology, how the routing table will get created, like that. So this is a normal, the way how the OSPF is working on or any other protocol is working on, the same way it works. But here, what is the problem is that it can only work with the Cisco router. That is the problem. So we need to understand that how the things are working on this, how advertised distance makes a difference between the feasible distance and successor and other things. What are the descriptions of that? What does it mean, the AD? What does it mean, the FD? And what is successor and what is feasible successor? We will see that now. AGRP tables. AGRP table, AGRP will be creating three tables. One is a neighborship table. Another one is a topology table. Third one is a routing table. So these three tables are created by automatically by AGRP when it is doing the network intelligence like that. Whenever it is trying to find out the neighbor devices and all, it will be doing this tables. Neighbor tabling, it will be the all the neighbors will be identified and it will be done on that. And the topology table contains all the destinations advertised by the neighboring routers. Routing table, it contains the AGRP successor routes on this. These three tables are very much important. And moreover, the table number is like that. Number one is a neighbor table. Number two is topology table. Number three is routing table. These three tables are created by the order of execution. This is the order of execution. Number one, number two, number three, like this. With this, AGRP will be creating the tables and it will be presenting the tables to us when we are supplying the commands to see what all the outputs are there in this. Then AD versus FD, advertised distance with the feasible distance. Advertised distance, also referred as reported distance, is the cost of between the next hop router and the destination. Feasible distance is the cost between the local router to the next hop router plus next hop router's AD to the destination network. Means the fullest distance from the source to destination, I can call that is a feasible distance. And the source to the next hop, that is called the reported distance, we can call it as. It is not so much confusing. Whatever the router which is the nearest one, that will be given us like a reported distance. When the source try to reach the destination complete path, when we try to determine that, that is called as a feasible distance. That's it. Successor and feasible successor. Successor is a neighboring router that has a least cost path to a destination that is guaranteed not to be part of the routing loop. Successor routes are offered to the routing table to be used in the forwarding packets. Multiple successor can exist if they have the same FD. Means if the metric values are quite same, then multiple successor can exist in the same table. It's possible. What is feasible successor? Feasible successor is a neighbor that is closer to the destination, but it is not the least cost path. Okay, means like a best path is called as a successor. Other cost paths, like somewhere here on the something similar like that, they will be called as like a feasible successor. A feasible successor ensures loop free topology because it must have an AD less than the FD of the current successor route. A feasible successor are selected at the same time as successors, but are kept in the topology table as backups to the successor routes. The topology table can maintain multiple feasible successors for a destination. Passive routes versus active routes. Passive route is considered passive when the router is not performing the recomputation on the route. Passive is the operational stable state. Active route is active when it is undergoing the recomputation. Means you can take it in this way. If it is a passive, it's a working route. Through that only the packets are being sent out. Active route means it is a failed route. It tries to make the connectivity actually. So you should take it as like in a the reverse way on this. Next. Key AGRP technologies: reliable transport protocol, neighbor discovery recovery mechanism, protocol dependent modules, dual finite machine. Dual is algorithm which has been used in the AGRP. So how does it been working with that? How the dual is working on to make things to happen on this. Responsible for guaranteed ordered delivery of AGRP packet to all the neighbors, that is RTP. Neighbor discovery recovery mechanism enables the AGRP routers to dynamically learn when their neighbors become unreachable or inoperative by periodically sending the small hello packets. Protocol dependent modules, responsible for network layer protocol specific requirements such as IP, IPv6, Apple Talk, and the novel network. Dual finite state machine. Diffusing update algorithm is a routing algorithm that tracks all the routes advertised by all neighbors and uses distance information known as composite metric to select the efficient loop-free path to all the destinations. Reliable transport protocol, that is an RTP, which has been used by AGRP to find out many informations like AGRP cannot use the services of UDP or TCP since IPX, Apple Talk do not use the TCP/IP protocol suite. So RTP is a transport layer protocol uniquely used by AGRP for delivery and reception of the AGRP packets. RTP is similar to TCP, is the Cisco proprietary. RTP provides reliable and unreliable service as the situation warrants. Reliable packets update query and reply requires explicit acknowledgement when unreliable packets hello and acknowledgement do not. This is how the neighbor discovery is happening. Neighbor discovery and recovery has been happening on this. When the router is sending the hello, this is router A who is on the link. And the update comes in here. Here is the routing information. And then the original router A is saying the thanks for the information. And it is giving the update routing information. Then the acknowledgement comes. Like, so then they are converged. This is how the neighbor discovery is happening on this. Neighbor discovery can happen only the directly connected routers. Directly connected routers in our case, the A and B are directly connected routers. So they are working together. Protocol dependent modules. Various routed protocols are supported through its PDMs. Provides independence from the routed protocols. PDMs are modular, scalable, and adaptable. EHRP can adapt to a new or revised routed protocols. PDMs protect EHRP from painstaking revision. Each PDM is responsible for all functions related to its specific routed protocol. Protocol dependent modules. These are all the dependent. It's like a neighbor table for Apple Talk is there, neighbor table for IPX is there, and neighbor table for the IP is there. For each and every protocol, it will be keeping the different neighbor table for that. And the topology table for the Apple Talk, IPX, and IP. Then the routing table for Apple Talk, IPX, and IP. There is a different thing. All three are different. Neighborship table is different for all the protocols. Topology table is different for all the protocols. Routing table is different for all the protocols. That's why it has been a most hybrid protocol, we call it as NIC. So let's go. Finite machine. Dual uses the neighbor and topology tables to calculate route information. When a link fails, dual looks for a feasible successor in its neighbor and topology tables. It compares all routes advertised by neighbors by using a composite metric for each route. Lowest cost paths are then inserted into the routing table. EHRP packets. What is the way of the EHRP packets are working? EHRP packets using the five packet types to maintain its various tables and establish complex relationship with the neighbor routers. Hello packet, acknowledgement packets, update packets, query packets, and the reply packets. There are five packets. Through this, EHRP works with all the neighboring routers as well. We'll see one by one. Hello packets. EHRP relies on hello packets to discover, verify, and rediscover the neighbor routers. EHRP hello packets are multicast to 224.0.0.10. Hello packets are always sent unreliably and therefore do not require any acknowledgements. Here the hello packet is going on, coming back, going on, coming back, and going on, coming back. Hello packet is used to discover the neighbors and form adjacencies. Unreliable, so no response required from the recipient. Acknowledgement packets are used to indicate receipt of any EHRP packet during a reliable exchange. To be reliable, a sender's message must be acknowledged by the recipient. Acknowledgement packets are dataless hello packets and unicast. Update packets. After the local router discovers a new neighbor, update packets are sent to the new neighbor. Update packets are also used when a router detects a topology change. The router sends a multicast update packet to all neighbors, alerting them to the change. All update packets are sent reliably. Here it's a reliable thing is required. That's what the update is going on from here to here, everywhere the people are, you know, updates are happening on this. Next, query and reply packets. Query and reply packets are sent when a destination has no feasible successors. Both packet types are sent reliably. A query packet is multicasted to other EHRP routers during the route recomputation process. Query packets are always multicast. A reply packet is used to respond to a query to instruct the originator not to recompute the route because feasible success exists. Reply packets are always unicast. Like this is how the query and reply packets are coming up. When query sent, reply goes on. When query sent, reply goes on. These are all the packet types we see. Hello packets, acknowledgement packets, update packet, query packet, then reply packet. Hello used to discover the EHRP routers. Acknowledgement to acknowledge with the receipt. Convey the routing protocol to the known destinations. Query used to get specific information from the neighbor router. Reply used to respond a query. Like this, it goes. So these are on the five packet type. We've seen that. Then we'll see about initial route discovery. Initial route discovery means how the neighbor router has been found out and what are the protocols they are using it. We've seen already that there is a hello packet, acknowledgement packet, update packet, and all coming out. What is the order of sequence like that it goes on? Number one, I am router A, who is on the link? And the B router is saying that, hey, hello, I am router B, is saying the hello. And the router A is coming back with that my complete routing information that is coming as an update. And the number three, it's nothing but thanks for the information, that is an acknowledgement. Then again, it is giving that update. It is making it like a topology table here. This is my complete routing information. It is sending it to the table. Then when the B receives all information about the A, it is making it its own routing table or a topology table. Then it is giving that acknowledgement as a thank for the information. So number one, number two, number three, number four, number five, number six, like this. So this is the order of execution. First is saying hello, then it is saying hello. Along with that, it will be giving the update for that. Then it is making it to the table on this. Then it is saying the acknowledgement is saying, okay, I see I have all the information. I'm giving my update also to you. Then after getting the update, this guy is saying that, okay, acknowledgement. It has been converged. Converged in the sense, both the routers has the same similar information about the topology which has been there in the network on this. Okay. So this is how the order of executions are done on this. Next, EHRP operations. EHRP selects the primary and backup routes and injects those into the topology table. Selects the primary in the sense it is going to be the successor. Backup means a feasible successor. Primary routes are then moved to the routing table. Means successor will be going to the routing table on this. IP EHRP neighbor table, neighbor's IP address, local router exit interface to the neighbor, like that list of directly connected adjacent EHRP neighbor routers and the local interface to exit to reach it. That is nothing but the neighbor table. The neighbor table will be containing list of the people who are the neighbors and which what will be the interface to reach to the neighbors like that. Then IP EHRP topology table, list of all routes learned from each EHRP neighbor and identify the successor routes and the feasible successor routes on this. Destination one, FD, AD, via each neighbor. Then it goes to the routing table. That's what I said. One is a, first is a neighborship table. Second is a topology table. Third one is a routing table. In the routing table, we'll be seeing only the best routes. That is nothing but a successor route. List of the best routes from the EHRP topology table and other routing process. This is the best routes. Now it's clear. We see that is nothing but the, first it is creating the neighborship table. Second, it is creating the topology table. Third, it is creating the routing table. So it is a very simpler one. We can easily understand that when we are just configuring this routers to talk to each other, then you'll understand. Next. EHRP tables, router C table. This is the router C. We see in here, this is the router C. How the router C is making the tables as such. Router C has got A and B as a next hop. Through the interfaces, there are two interfaces are there, one and two interfaces are there. Through Ethernet 0, it is connected to the router A. Through Ethernet 1, it is connected to the router B. So this is nothing but a neighborship table. Then the topology table has been made. Topology table, it is saying that there are two networks, or actually there are similar networks only, 10110 only, it is there. Both are specifying about the 10110, can you say? So this is coming from router A, this is coming from router B, E0 and E1, through the interfaces it is saying. Then the routing table goes on this. Then the network has been taken as a 10110 by seeing the, you know, least metric distance or something other, it will be picking up the neighbor as such, it goes to that. So when the router C tries to reach the 10110, it will choose the path of A because of it is having the least metric on this. This is just a normal how the EHRP operations are happening. C is having a two path to reach the 10110. This is the destination. This is the source you take. First path and second path. When both are becoming the neighbor, when A and B is becoming the neighbor to C, C will find out which will be the best path to reach the destination. So because of the A has got the least metric, means the fastest route. So A route has been chosen. You see that? A route has been chosen. So simple. It's very simple. When you just come here, you'll understand that. Okay, next. How the LEAGRP neighborship table will look like? SRTT. See that? This is the table, which is actually, it's a good one. Actually, I took it from the Cisco side on this. We are running this command from R1. R1's console. Show IP AGRP neighbor sometime. First one, what is that? H is nothing but list of order in which the peering session was established. The specified neighbor with starting from the zero means he is the first neighbor. Number starts with the zero only in Cisco. Okay, then what is the address of that neighbor? This is address, IP address. Then through which interface it has been, local interface, receiving the EAGRP hello packets, means the R1 router, what interface it is connecting to the neighbor. That is the meaning. Next, hold. How long the entry is in the neighborship table, seconds remaining before declaring the neighbor is down. The current hold time is reset to the maximum hold time whenever hello packet is received. Like that. So it will be keep on counting it until it's saying the neighbor is down or something. So uptime, amount of time since this neighbor was added to the neighbor table for last 7 minutes and 22 seconds, this neighbor is staying in the neighborship table of R1. Then SRTT is a smooth round trip timer, retransmit interval are used by RTP to manage reliable EAGRP packets. SRTT indicates how long it takes for this neighbor to respond to reliable packets. RTO indicates how long to wait for before neighbor to coming like with no ACKs. It is a very higher, I can just say that. Queue count should always be zero. Otherwise, there is a congestion on the link. This is saying about the how much the traffic to reach the neighbor or something. Next, sequence number. This sequence number of the last update, query or reply packet that was received from the neighbor. These are all informations, you may not be requiring it at the time of starting. Until this much is very much enough for you. Okay. When you are configuring the EAGRP, you just need to see only this much of information. This is enough for you. Means how many hosts are there? What is the address of that neighbor? Through which interface we are connecting? How long the entry is in the neighborship table? This much is required for neighbor table information. Next, we'll see topology table. This is the second table. Second table which contains all information about the entire network. So topology table has got the same router we are running this command called show IP AGRP topology. Topology, the first one is a P. P indicates this is in either it is in a passive state or is in an active state. This is in a passive state because P is actually passive, means it's a working. Then the next, destination network. What is the network? And it is a mask. Then number of successors, how many successor to reach this destination? One successor, feasible distance to the destination, FD. This is a metric calculation has been done on this. Then next hop address for the successor. How do we reach the successor? Via which router, via which IP we are reaching this. Then what is the feasible distance of the destinations? Then advertised distance, FD and AD are given, means the reported distance. Through outbound interface, we are reaching this network. Like, so this is information which gives us very, very good information about that. When we are running the command, it's the show IP AGRP topology. See, P is passive. The codes are there. With this, we can identify that. P passive. Now, this is a passive route. Passive route means a working route. A means active. Active means it's not working. Update still going on. Q query is going on. Reply is coming back. Something like that, it will keep on happening. So when you say stuck in route, that is a different route. Okay, that is a very problematic thing in AGRP. Maybe like the neighborship is not so reachable, it beyond the reachable condition or something, we will be coming into this SIA state. Okay, now it's a P. So order of execution, it comes up like what is P, what is its address, and what is the successor, and everything we can able to see on. Next, routing table. How the AGRP routing table will be looking like? Actually, the routing table has been created by the local router only by using the one of the resources, either it is a OSPF or EHRP or BGP or RIP or any other protocol or study route, whatever it may be, like that. So now the explanation goes on. When I enter in the command called show IP route, the first the letter which will say that which resource is giving this information, that is a EHRP route. D means D is a code which is talking about the EHRP information. Then the destination network with its own mask is /16. What is the administrative distance of the EHRP? That is 90. What is the feasible distance? That is, this is actually given by the EHRP dual algorithm. And this is given as like a normal standard which has been applied on the, you know, EHRP for that. 90 is the default AD. Via which, you know, which IP and how long the entry is in there, like time indicate last update packet received. And then through which interface we are trying to reach that network, like this. And one more thing. This is like a summary route also. We'll be getting the summary and no order summary and other things which are coming up, like classless and classful and other things and all. We will see that later. So three tables we've seen that. One is a neighborship table. How does it look like? Second one is a topology table. How does it look like? Third one is a routing table. These are all the examples we are seeing in the Cisco route, not in any other routers. Yeah. Now let us go to the, Okay. Now the routing table we've seen, we'll see the administrative distances. What is the default administrative distances are assigned for EHRP protocol? EHRP summary router has got a 5. Internal EHRP has got a 90. External EHRP has got a 170. Routes distributed into EHRP will have 170. Internally, within the same AD number, something which is created, that is a 90. Whenever there is a summary route has been configured, there is a default, is a 5. We can change. Can we change this distance? Definitely, we can change it by the command called EHRP distance command. It's possible. That is should be done by the admin, experienced people only has to do that. So let us go to the next slide. How the metric calculation has been done in EHRP? EHRP uses a composite metric, which can be based on the following metrics: bandwidth, delay, reliability, and load. Bandwidth is nothing but the speed of the link. Delay is nothing but how many milliseconds, maybe like it tried to take to reach the destination. Reliability is how much reliable the link is, and what sort of a load I can put on the link like that. So these much informations are being discussed under the metric calculations. Only bandwidth and delay are default. By default, it has been used. If it is often incorrectly stated that the EHRP can also use the smallest MTU in the path. In actual fact, MTU is included in the EHRP routing update, but it is not actually used in the metric calculations. So one more metric is there that is called as an MTU, maximum transmission unit, that is not included in the composite metric calculations. Metric calculations are not including the MTU. It will be including only these four parameters. Under these four parameters, only two are default, bandwidth and delay. Okay, let's go to the explanations about this. Implementing the EHRP. The information necessary to implement the EHRP routing protocol includes the following. How do we implement it? The IP addresses to be configured on individual router interfaces. EHRP AS number used to enable the EHRP. All list of routers and interfaces on which EHRP is to be enabled. Metrics that need to be applied to specific interfaces are EHRP traffic engineering. In the implementation plan, EHRP, the tasks include the following: enabling the EHRP routing protocol, configuring the proper network statements, optionally configuring the metric to appropriate interfaces. These are all like implementation plans when it goes with the EHRP. Next, how do you verify the EHRP? When we configured it, we seeing some kind of, you know, neighborship is coming up, the routes are getting, you know, distributed from here to here to there. So how do we verify that? After implementing the EHRP, verification should confirm proper deployment on each router. Verification tasks include verifying EHRP neighbor relationship, EHRP topology table that is populated with the necessary information. IP routing table is populated with the necessary information, that there is a connectivity in the network between the routers and other devices, that EHRP behaves as expected in case of topology changes by testing the link failure and router failure events. So this is how we are going to verify the EHRP whether it is working properly or not by running the specific Cisco commands in the console. Configuring the EHRP. How do we configure the EHRP? EHRP configuration is okay. You just need to take a pick up the network numbers from the interfaces configured with the masks, and you'll have to open up that router EHRP from the level. Here, just say router EHRP AS number. Then it'll just say the network numbers should be specified. Then the classful will happen. Classful in the sense, it may not understand the subnet mask information on that. That is called as a classful. Even if I am configuring 172.16.1.0 with a 24-bit mask, actually speaking, 172 is nothing but a class B address. By default, it will be assigning the /16 mask only. This is called a classful. Whatever you configure over there, but when you are not specifying the configurations under the router EHRP commands, the EHRP will be automatically applying the default mask to the network numbers. That is called as classful addressing. Next, how do you configure the classless? When we're configuring the classless, in the sense, EHRP has got the capability of either it can work as a classful or it can work as a classless also. But all the other protocols, ECU, OSPF, and other things are actually classless by default. So, but here we just need to mention it. The mask information has to be mentioned. Else, we just need to say no auto summary command. When you're just saying that, EHRP will work like a classless routing protocol. Means it can even understand the mask information also, which has been assigned to the interfaces directly. Okay. Else, it'll directly do only the auto summary. You know, like auto summarization can be done. When you say no auto summary, in the sense, it'll be switching off the summarizing things. Like, so this is how we'll be configuring this. See here, explicitly the mask informations are given on this, both the routers. That's why I can just say that this is a configuration example of no auto summary like that. And verifying the EHRP, how do we verify that? Verifying the EHRP, we just need to see the section command. We can use that. This is a experienced people will be using the section command to see that EHRP configuration only in the router configured. Then you can just say normally say show IP route command, which will be showing the routes of D routes will be shown. D, D, D. D means EHRP. D means the router which has received the routing update through the EHRP protocol, which will be labeled as D in the routing table of the router. So we can identify the D route means that has been understood and that has been learned by the EHRP protocol. Next, verifying the routing for information on the router, like show IP protocols, we can just say. This is the Cisco command, which will be telling us like how many protocols are configured in a local router. When you type the show IP protocols command, this will be giving you the all information about what all the protocols are configured, EHRP configured, OSPF configured, BGP configured, like that. In our case, we are seeing the EHRP. In this EHRP, we've seen that there are K values are here. K is nothing but our metrics we talk about. Metrics, K1, K2, K3, K4, K5. This is what we discussed about that earlier. That is a bandwidth, delay, load, reliability, then MT. These five parameters. That's why the five parameters of the K values are given on this. The maximum hop count is 100, variance is 1, something like that. Just keep on going on. Routing path for the network, something. All the information will get it on this. And we can even see that administrative distance value also 90 and 170 something. Okay, this command is a very useful command. Like you will come to know that how many protocols are activated in local router. You can identify that. It's not only EHRP. If you have configured OSPF also, it will show that as a next paragraph like an OSPF. Next. We can see the show IP EHRP neighbor command. You see that how many neighbors are formed, how many directly connected routers are there, which are running with an EHRP will be shown in the neighborship, show IP EHRP neighbor command. Then we'll see the verify routing protocol information from the router. Show IP EHRP topology. Topology will be giving the complete information about that. How many, the paths for reaching the destinations, how many paths are existing, how many successes are there, how many feasible successes are, what is their distance? What is the feasible distance? What is the advertised distance? Like that. All information will be able to see on this one. Next, show IP route EHRP. This command will be giving you only the EHRP routes only will be given. You see that D routes only be given. When you just say show IP route means it will be showing all the other routes also. Directly connected also it will show. And the D also will be showing. Then show IP EHRP interfaces command, you can type it. Then interfaces command means which are all the interfaces the EHRP has been activated. Those, how many packets are sent to received? Something like that. It will be what is the, you know, like smooth round trip time, multicast flow time, and all these things will be shown on this. So show commands are very important for us to do the troubleshooting as well. So when we are running the show IP EHRP neighbor, then only we'll come to know whether the neighbor is present or not. People will be directly jumping into that routing table and see, hey man, this route is not existing. Why? How? Neighbor is not there. Neighborship is not getting formed at all. So we'll have to go by one. Neighborship table first, topology table second, routing table third, like that. So don't go in reverse, okay? Then we can do the debugging. Debugging, actually speaking about, debugging cannot be run in the you know, the production running routers. It's not allowed because it may crash routers also. Router has already been busy on handling the data traffic, which has been done on the through the interfaces on this. And EHRP, whether you would like to see about the EHRP, how does it work? You can directly just run the debug EHRP updates packets like that. So many you know, like debug commands are there for EHRP. In that one, what we can say, like in production, it is not allowed to run it. Then how do I run it in my production route? It means you just need to ask for a downtime from the customer, saying for I would like to run it for 10 minutes or 15 minutes, like that. So maintenance time need to be taken. Then we'll be running the debug commands on that. So we will be able to collect that immediately in the outputs. Then we'll stop the debug immediately to stop the router to get overwhelming on this one. So that's a way that we will be saving our job, as well as we can save the router's health as well as the conditions also. So here it is sending them, whether it is a hello packets are coming up or going on, the yellow color highlighting is showing that hello packets are going on. Something. So this is how we'll be identifying that. There are so many other debug commands are also there available for EHRP protocol, especially. We can run all those debug commands in a laboratory router. Please run it in a laboratory so that you'll be able to understand that how things are being done on that. Next. That's all. We come up to the conclusion of this, you know, EHRP, because EHRP is known to everyone. So if you have any questions on this EHRP, you can ask me. I will be able to answer your questions. And as usual, I would like to tell you that please subscribe to my channel. That is a YouTube channel. And if you have any questions on the people who are watching this my channel on my YouTube, you can put in a comment on this. I will be able to answer you. Or you can send an email to me, or you can directly WhatsApp me on this number. I'm very much ready to serve you. And if you have any questions, you can ask me directly now, or else I will be going for a small, you know, like some simulation, which I can create it on the GNS3. I can show you all the routers, how do they operating on a GN, how do they operating on the, you know, with the EHRP protocol on this. Okay, so no questions. Somebody is chatting. Okay, he's saying Kishu is saying okay. So I guess we can go for some configuration of the EHRP. Let me take up that configuration. It may take at least 2 to 3 minutes for a GNS3 to start up. Please wait until then. So EHRP is a very easier, you know, like easier to configure that protocol. And verifications also quite easier. We can integrate that all the routing protocols in the GNS3 itself. It is very much possible. We just need to have that IOS of the routers. It is required. I am using the 7200 router. It's quite easier one. And we can pull up any routers up, like around four, five routers also. It's possible. It doesn't take much memory as well. Now it is getting started. Please wait. So when we are trying to configure the EHRP, we will be pulling up the router and connecting to them via the switch or hub or something. Then we'll configure with the proper IP addresses. Then we'll have to activate the EHRP protocol for all the routers in this. Then we will verify it with the verification commands on show IP EHRP neighbors, show IP EHRP topology, and show IP EHRP, show IP route. We can run the three tables, we can find out that. Very simple to configure. And it is very easy to simulate that environment in the JNS itself with the Cisco boxes on this. Jennifer will be supporting only the OSPF. So we can see only the HRP on the Cisco routers. We'll see that now. Let it be ready. I'll start showing you that configuration sound. Okay, now it should be ready now. Let me type it like a demo on Azure. I'll just do that. I click OK. I don't want any latest information. Yeah, okay, thank you. Okay, let's go for Cisco 7215. Something like that, I can just take that. One router and two routers and the three routers I'll take. So three routers I've taken it, R1, R2, and R3. I'll connect them with the interfaces 10210, 11211. Like this, then I'll do that. F10, F11, F11. Like this. So what I do, I will start this one. All the three routers are getting started one by one. And I can take up that consoles after some time because the CPU limit has to go down slowly. Like, because initially it will be shooting up because all three routers are started. It's saying some 19% of the CPU. Oh, now it is gone to 76. It'll get reduced. Once the routers are getting settled down because it is booting up now, it may take some memory as well as CPU cycles also. It'll get, reduced. Then we will take the console and we'll start configuring the EAJRP protocol in these three routers. Getting reduced. Let me see. Okay, let me take the R1 console. I'll take the console of R1. It's coming up. Coming up. Okay, so R1 is ready. So I'll do the R2. One by one, I'm just taking that. R2 is ready. Then I'll take the R3. Okay, R1, R2, R3, all are ready. Now I will just start configuring this. I can just say show version. It's a 7200 router, which is 15.2 with OS, which is running on this. We'll configure that. Interface loopback 0 IP address. 1111, 24-bit mask, I given that no shit is not required here. So I will go for configuring the interface directly, 1/0. That is what the interface I connected here. So I'll configure this. IP address, 192.168.1.1. No shutdown. Okay, then I will configure that router, EAGRP, any number I can use that. One second, let me come out of this. So it will show the all the options as well. Router question mark. This many routing protocols I can configure on this. So what I'm going to do now is EAGRP. That is nothing but enhanced interior gateway routing protocol. EAGRP. I'll just say. Then if I just give the whatever. Router EAGRP. Question mark. It's saying the autonomous system number has to be given. So I will give the number as a 10. Then I'll add to specify the network statement. What are the networks are there from this one? 192.168.1.0 will be the network because it is a /24. I'll type it 1.0. Then here it's a 1111 I computed, but it is a 24-bit mask I given. By seeing this, you can just identify this is a class A network, but I'm going to give the class C, the mask for this 1110. I'll just say no auto summary. When I'm typing that no auto summary, this becomes a classless office. Means the router will go and fetch the information, what has been memory has been, what is the subnet mask has been configured on the interface as well. So let me go back to the R2, config terminal, same way, interface loopback 0, IP address 2222, 255255.0. Then FA1/0, I had to configure. 192.168.1.2, I'll make it out here. No shutdown, it's very much required. So this router is going to talk to R3 also. So I need to configure FA11 also here. Interface FA1/1. You can do the shortcut, no problems. 192.168.2.1. 25.255.0. I have to use the same routing protocol activations, routing EHRP 10 network 2.2.2.2.0, then another network 192.168.1.0, then 2.0. Oh, order summary. That's very much right. End right. So now you just see that already the neighborship has been made. We will come back and see the neighborship here. Let me come back to this router to configure the RP as well. Interface will go loop back 0, IP address, I'll give it as a 3. Then I'll have to configure FA11. That is what been connecting to the R2 router. R2 is connecting to that. So FA11 I'll have to configure. 192.168.2.2 I'll configure. No shutdown. As usual, we need to increase, we have to use the same similar autonomous system number on all the routers. Network 333.0, another network is 192.168.2.0. Now auto summary, end, right. It's done. Very good. Done. So now we completed the configurations of the EHRP on all three routers as well. So now I am going to do it from the R1 directly. I'll just say show IP EHRP. It's saying the one neighbor, 192.168.1.2. When I go to the R2, I should be able to see the two neighbors, EHRP neighbor, right? That is a spelling mistake. I see 1.1 is the first router, 2.2 is the third router. So two neighbors I'm seeing. When I go to R3, show IP EHRP neighbor. It goes as the 2.1 is the same, similar, only one neighbor. Through this interface FA11, how long the holding, how long it has been running, 39 seconds has been made, like that. So let us see the next table, show IP, EHRP, topology. It shows that. Here it is showing. 192.168.2.0, to reach that, we have one successor, that FD value is 30720, via which interface, 1/0 interface. To reach the 2220 network, there is one successor, his AD is this value. And via this interface, and via this interface IP and the interface number. To reach 1.0, this is the FD value through this interface. To reach 3330, FD value is this through this interface, because it is reaching through only one interface outside. Here it is reaching through this one. That's why it is saying all the networks are reachable by FA10. So let us see the same information here. Show IP, EHRP, topology. Topology. Yeah, okay. Now you see that. 2.0 FD 22220. That is a local only. That is an FD. Why are the loopback zero it is saying? 192.168.1.0. That is coming from the adjacent routers. That is through that connected. 333 is coming from the third router. 111 is coming from the first router. So 333 is reached by 1/1 interface. 111 is reached by 1/0 interface. Exactly it is saying. This is the one, let me type it here. This is 1.1.1.1/24. And here, this is 2.2.2.2/24. This is 3.24.25, okay. So like that, it is exactly giving the proper information about that. Then let us go to the 3, show IP, EHRP. Topology, top is okay. So 1, 2, 2 is coming from, second router. 1 is coming from first router. 3 and 2.0 is a local one. That's why it is saying like this. Now let us see the third table. That is nothing but show IP route, R-O-U-T. Now you see that D routes are there. It's showing the D route. D route is nothing but adjacent routers, which are responding, which are giving the updates about the destinations. That is called as a D. D is nothing but EHRP. I say that D, 2220 is coming from the second router. 333 is coming from the third router. 192.168.2.0, that is coming from the third router. Like that. So this is how it is working. So if you like to see only the EHRP route, I'll type EHRP I'll be seeing only the D routes. You see that? Only the D routes here, not the other routes. Similar, I'll try it here in R2. Let's say the entry is bigger because it is a heavy 1, 2, 3. 191.6.0, 1.0, 2.0, and everything has been given. There are many routes as a EHRP. You will see it. EHRP working. 1 and 3 is being identified. Let me go to R3. Type the same command, show IP route. Then I'll see the EHRP also. 1, 2, and 1.0. These are all learned by the EHRP from other way. So these are all the three tables which we seen here. If you like to see the interfaces, show IP EHRP interfaces. I will show that. Let me make it slightly bigger so you'll see this. Let me try the command again. So yeah, now you are seeing that. How much reliable, unreliable, which is going on, something like that, maximum PR. We can run the same command here also, show IP EHRP interface. It's a spelling mistake. It's here. I can run the same command here also. Let me run it here. It's coming up. So we can see all of them and we can run the debug also. We're running the debug. Debug IP EHRP slide. Just say summary. Then debug IP EHRP notification. Or we can just run like debug EHRP packets. That will be giving the immediate reply. You see that? EHRP sending hello on FA11. Because it is only one router. So let me stop all by saying you all means stopping all the debugs. Here I can just run debug EHRP packets. We'll be seeing the updates going on every interface. 10 and 11. Let me stop it immediately, otherwise my PC will be going so much heavy. So you can just see that. Just running the hello packets on this one. FA1/0, length and type and other things. EHRP received hello. Received hello, it is saying that. Sending hello, it's saying. Sending hello. Received hello and sending hello. This is like how they are talking to each other. Like. So this is about the EHRP, very simplest protocol to get configured on the Cisco routers. We seen the three routers, we taken that. And the EHRP 10 is an autonomous system which is running on this. Like that, you just say. EHRP 10 is the one which I configured. So about this, this is the EHRP. So if you have any questions, you can ask me directly. And you can join my channel by subscribing it to that, and you can introduce to your friends and colleagues and relatives regarding my channel. We'll be updating with the newest topics on by next week on this as usual. And you can send me an email when you would like to receive this, you know, the slides and the recording as well. I'll be sending it to you right away. Maybe in just next half an hour, I'll be sending it to you. Okay, no doubts as such. Okay, thanks. Very good. So everyone is saying that there is no doubts at all because it is quite an easier protocol to get configured. It's a bigger, bit older also. But anyway, I'm just starting like a series of this protocol introductions and the further configurations as well. Okay, so people can give me your email addresses. I'll send you this, you know, slides and the recordings as well. Okay. Yeah, I'll be sharing that video link also, no worries. Okay. And I'll be sending you this information to you. The PPTs and slides and other things will be sending it. And please recommend my channels to your friends and relatives and all, colleagues and other people. So we'll be keep on updating every week. There will be a new chapter will be talked on. So it will be completely a technical information. It's a complete free channel. So you can just go and watch it out. And please do not forget to subscribe to my channel. So if you have any questions, you can ask me or you can send an email onto this. And, you know, and if anyone has got any doubts, okay, yes, some other people has given the mail addresses. Okay, anyway. Okay then, and I'll be closing this meeting by this time. So we'll meet next week with some new chapters as well. Thank you very much for joining today. Thank you, bye.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.